Hi, this is Mark Mulbert of Digital Metrology. If you're involved in honing, chances are you're involved with the measurement of crosshatch angle. Now, crosshatch angle is simply the angle between the two texture directions generated by honing. Now, the measurement of that angle has been a challenge. In many cases, easy methods are employed, but they're not necessarily repeatable. They involve operator judgment. More expensive methods are out there. They're highly automated and require delicate fixturing. Recently, however, a couple of friends have introduced me to some USB microscopes. I'm holding in my hand a $90 USB microscope. If you do a Google search for USB microscope, you'll find hundreds of different USB microscopes online, ranging in price from anywhere from about $26 up to about $100. These USB microscopes, almost all of them have some focusing mechanism. Here's a ring for focusing, and many of them have adjustable lighting. This is very useful that I have dimmable lighting on this particular scope. So if I simply place this microscope on a surface to be measured and launch my HatchView software, you'll see that we can image and calculate crosshatch angle in real time. This is revolutionary stuff to take off-the-shelf microscopes at very low costs, well under $100, and have a real-time metrology device reporting something like crosshatch angle. Now, a cool thing about many of these microscopes is there's a zoom, where if I keep turning the focusing wheel, I can zoom, in this case, up to a 250 times magnification. I'll add a little more light so we can see that. At that 200 magnification, we can start to see some really interesting detail on this honing process, and we're still calculating angles if need be, but we can start to approach things like torn and folded material, which are, again, very difficult to measure and describe. Now, as you see, I'm holding this camera at a right angle. That's probably not the best, most functional orientation because we'd have to section the bore to make that happen. So let's spin this camera around back in an axial position where we can slide it into a bore more easily. I'm going to adjust my focus and lighting back to where we had it. There we go. Now, in this axial position, you can see that the image is rotated. That's not a problem. The HatchView software will allow me to rotate the image, so now my imaging is in line with reality and my angles are correct. Now, depending on how your angles are specified, you may want to use an included horizontal angle or included angles relative to horizontal. This may require some fixturing of your camera. We can report vertical angle or vertical included angles. In other cases, we can turn the angle completely off and do some imaging like of this 6-inch scale I have next to me. And there's the standard magnification. If I zoom into the high magnification, you see the camera once again comes into focus and I can see a lot of detail. Each of these lines, by the way, is 1/100th of an inch. This line spacing, those are hundredths. So these handheld USB cameras are providing a ton of metrology capability, and they're just begging for software solutions like the HatchView project. So, if you're dealing with crosshatch angle or know someone who is, be sure and point them to digitalmetrology.com and tell them about HatchView. Thank you.